Anybody here into funny cars? You like funny car? All right, I had a funny car. 74 Gremlin with four different size tires. I tell you, people seen it, thought it was hilarious. I think NASCAR ought to pull a page out from golf and spruce it up a little bit. Get the older folks back out on the track. Have a senior circuit. The Maylocks 100. Everybody driving around with their blinker on, looking for a Cracker Barrel to stop and eat at out there. That'd be nice. There's Rusty Wallace and the Can't Go number 2 X-Lax Ford out there, coming in for an oil change and a prostate check. I think the cool thing about NASCAR is, though, if you got enough money, you can sponsor and name any race you want. That's pretty fan-friendly right there. And that's going to happen one day, too. You watch. Some old redneck going to win the lottery, going to be pissed off at his neighbor. Turn on ESPN, they'll be like, don't forget, tomorrow night we're going to bring you to my buddy Daryl's A Big Fat Lazy Piece of Crap 400 right here on ESPN. Check that out. My favorite NASCAR race about 3 years ago, Mark Martin lost that race by that much. And I'm going to tell you something. I love Mark Martin. He is a good dude and a great kisser. And let me say this. But he lost the race by that much, which really stinks, because if he'd have stayed in his Viagra car, he'd have won by like that much. That was a bad mistake right there. That's something that irritates me, Viagra. What? And the people getting hooked on that. People don't even need it. I don't know why they use Viagra. They shouldn't be able to buy it. My nephew's on Viagra, pissing me off. 17 years old, you believe that? He ain't got no sexual problem. He's just real skinny. And he said the boner helps keep his pants up. All right, so hey, Viagra. My grandpa's on Viagra just to keep his hopes up. I got a buddy of mine's an herbalist, and he's real tiny down there, but he don't like drugs or nothing, so he put some Miracle-Gro on there. He's still tiny, and now he's got an ass full of thistles. But I don't need Viagra, though. My problem is I'm too quick. That's my problem. I'm too fast. My wife get mad at me 30 seconds in. I'm done. She's like, good Lord, think about baseball. Think about baseball. I screwed that up and thought about softball. But I'm too sensitive. She got me some desensitizing cream. A lot of good that done. I put that on, and the next morning I told her cooking sucked and I hated her mom. But they got that stuff everywhere. Male enhancement's what they call that. And it irritates me, male enhancement. If you're using it, you're getting ripped off. That's all I know, because I seen some at the grocery store for $7. I'm like, $7? So I read the directions. You know what the directions said for $7? Squirt this on the palm of your hand, rub it on vigorously, and you'll get larger. No kidding. How many years of scientific research went on into that product right there? $7. I'll save you some money. Use Cool Whip. All right. It'll have the same effect. Just make sure you're done with dessert first, though, all right? Because that wouldn't be good. Boy, that was some good pumpkin pie. And some of that stuff you need a prescription for. And I ain't going to no doctor for no problem like that. I'd be there, rather be caught on the internet pooping in a pair of plastic shorts and do something like that. Not that I've done that, all right? I'm just saying. But I hate the doctor. You go in there, spend all this money, you still feel the same way. I spent $2,500 at a doctor one time, thought I had chronic fatigue syndrome. Turns out I'm just real lazy. They wanted to sell me this clean-out thing. All $500, you drink that, it'll clean out your system. $500? I could clean out my system with three White Castles and a Mountain Dew, for God's sake. I don't need that. That's $3.25 right there. They ripping me off. Tell you why else I hate going to the doctor, because you always got to sit in the waiting room next to some dirtbag got some weird disease. You don't know what the hell they got. They hacking everywhere. Then they want to be your best friend for 20 minutes. How you doing? I'm Jimmy. Get the hell away from me, Jimmy. Good Lord. You're getting your leprosy on me, for God's sake. But I had to go to the doctor a while back. I was freaking out. I really was. I felt a little lump right there. And I'm like, oh, damn, I got nut cancer. I'm dead, right? So I go to the doctor. Sure enough, I sit next to the woman. There was a woman in there, got crabs so daggone bad. Oh, they had to call in the fellas from the Deadliest Catch to figure this out on this girl in. Hey, it was horrible. It was horrible. So she's there. I'm freaked out. I got a little lump here. I'm like, I'm dead. And turns out I was fine. It was my penis. I had no idea. You know what I mean? I didn't. It had never sat in that direction before. It really hadn't. I didn't know what it was. But while I'm in there, the doctor had a magazine in there. So I was reading the magazine. And the cover of the magazine said, "The 6 sex mistakes men make while lovemaking." And I'm good. Good Lord, that's almost 2 a minute.